To get in the way before it happens.
To get a friend home safely. To not blame the victim. To look out for each other.
To not look the other way.
It's on us to stand up.
Stand in.
To take responsibility. It's on us. All of us. To stop sexual assault. Learn how. And take the pledge that it's on us, not yours.
Alright guys, the workout is complete. This is my second day using this oxygen mask. I used it yesterday for legs. I decided once you put it on, it's very difficult to breathe just sitting there. So this thing has like a plastic piece that goes and just kind of secures. It's almost like an oxygen mask for like a hospital or something like that. And the pieces that I have on allow the most oxygen to go in that it can possibly go. So I think it's like 2,000 feet above sea level is what this is supposed to feel like. Whatever. So yesterday I noticed that I fatigued very quickly during exercises. I had a very hard time with my cadence of breathing. And anytime you don't keep up the cadence with this thing as it's pulling air in, it's supposed to strengthen your diaphragm. You have a tendency to almost hyperventilate like you're having an asthma attack. It means you have to concentrate on your breathing very seriously or you're gonna like gasp for oxygen and wanna rip the thing off, which makes you wanna, through the whole workout, wanna rip the thing off. So you're concentrating more on this than you are actually on the exercises themselves. Now, if you might have noticed, some of the things I went a little bit lighter on, some things I went heavy on that I felt good on, but you fatigue so fast, you're not getting enough oxygen into the blood, there's not enough energy going through there, you fatigue quickly. So for bodybuilding benefits, I don't think this thing is very good at all. I don't think it's, bodybuilders should absolutely stay away from power lifts. I don't know what the reason would be Strong men maybe would want to use it during their endurance training because it does increase endurance, increases oxygen usability, and that's what it's been used for, endurance sports, for a long time. However, the thing that I thought was interesting was there was a study done on it. I'm not a big study guy, but the study was, I think they used it 3 times a week just during their cardio. No change in diet, no changing their other training, but the people lost body fat. Now, whether or not that's true, I don't know. So I figured I would give it a shot for a little while, using it during my training, using it during my cardio, which I'm doing a little bit of cardio now, to see if it sped things up. But the average person who doesn't like to exercise to begin with and can't stick to a diet is not going to be able to put this thing on their face and leave it on for whatever amount of time they're supposed to. It's more difficult for me to work out in this than it is to train or even stick to my diet. Even do cardio, I'd rather do cardio, I fucking hate cardio, than put this thing on my face. I mean, it takes a lot more discipline to not get this thing and rip it off your face than it does to stick to a diet. So therefore, if you're looking for an easier way out, which some people are like, oh, well, I could just go to the gym and put this thing on my face and I'll lose body fat. When you put this thing on your face, it's gonna be very hard for you to do your workout. It's gonna be even harder than normal, which means that even if you did lose body fat, you're still gonna be doing more exercise, outputting more energy, and getting less oxygen, which makes it even tougher. So far it's too early to tell whether or not this thing would help you lose body fat. Even if it did, I don't think it would be anything that would be like, this is the next best thing and you don't have to diet, you can use this. It might help a little bit, but as far as bodybuilding, no. Endurance, that's a whole nother ball game. So that's my review of these things. They're probably gonna be seen in gyms a lot more often. It's just starting to catch on now in our gym, and we have a large population of basketball endurance athletes, football, stuff like that, where endurance is key. But I bet you in the CrossFit gyms and stuff, you're gonna start seeing this thing a little bit. And in the general gyms themselves, you can get them at like any sporting goods store for about $80 a pop. And my suggestion is, if you're gonna do this, put the thing on and just kind of go through a workout real easy with it. Because real quickly, you forget that, you know, your heart rate jumps up when you're done with the exercise. So as you're doing the exercise, you feel okay. As soon as you rack the weights, your heart rate jumps up and your breathing increases and you can't get enough oxygen. So if you start taking shallow breaths, you feel like you're choking. So take it easy if you're gonna start out with this thing, if you're gonna give it a try. But as far as bodybuilding, thumbs down. BiosTraining@gmail.com. Leave comments
down below.
www.biosTraining.com is a blog. This is the Not For Bodybuilding Bicep, and we're out.